Well, hello everybody. So this is Dar here, and I'm doing this video as part of the witnessing series because I've come to understand that one of my favorite seed companies, recently favorite, but favorite nonetheless, one of my favorite seed companies, Baker Seeds, is hosting a white supremacist at their spring festival. My current understanding of the situation is that Cliven Bundy has been invited by Baker Seeds to come speak at their spring festival. That's what it shows on Facebook, and that's what Baker Seeds has been putting out on their Facebook account, and that's what it shows on the event page. Now, there are a lot of other wonderful speakers, and so far Baker Seeds has used this as an opportunity to say that they are engaging in diversity, their words, to make America truly great. Myself and a few friends, we've tried to reach out to Baker Seeds, online and express that we don't think this is the right thing for Missouri. And we certainly don't think that they should support and give platform to Cliven Bundy. I look at this as a growth opportunity. We all have growth opportunities in our life, and you know, I did some really, really wretched stuff before I learned better, and then somebody took the time to talk to me and help me understand things, and so my hope for Baker Seeds is that, you know, maybe if you see this video, you might hear some things that give you new ways to think, and perhaps you'll reconsider some of the choices that are currently being made. Well, let's just get right to the problems with Cliven Bundy. He's a racist, a flat-out racist. I'm gonna go ahead and read one of Cliven Bundy's comments, and it is not the comment in its entirety. You can look it up online, and I'll provide links so that you can get a sense of some of what Cliven Bundy has said regarding the topic of race, specifically black people. I quote, this is Cliven Bundy. I've often wondered, are they better off as slaves, picking cotton, and having a family life, doing things? Are they better off under government subsidy? They didn't get no more freedom, they got less freedom. He sees himself totally separate from people of color, from black folks, calling them they. He sees himself totally separate. He sees no connection between himself and black America. So we understand in advance, anytime he uses the phrase we the people, he is not talking about black people. Better off as slaves? Are you kidding me? This shows a fundamental lack of understanding, probably a willful lack of understanding of the cruelty of chattel slavery in this country. It's egregious. Better off picking cotton? So that is incredibly racist. And while it's true a variety of people did pick cotton, it is also true that picking cotton, as well as taking care of tobacco and other cash crops that did not bring food security, these here crops were completely subsidized for the white slave masters by the people of color they enslaved. White slave masters benefited greatly on the subsidizing with free labor that they violently enforced. And before you go saying, well, not everybody was a white slave master, a whole economy was built where a lot of people benefited directly and indirectly from the enslavement of people of color. Let's also look at this whole idea of black folks being under government subsidy. First off, the demographic in the U.S. that benefits the most from SNAP benefits are white people. Now let's talk about the racism involved with calling on white militias to violently keep hold of lands when he's just being asked to pay his fair share to the Bureau of Land Management for grazing rights. Cliven Bundy called upon, I shall read the list, the Oath Keepers, the White Mountain Militia, and the Praetorian Guard to violently enforce his entitlement to government lands. Now let me go ahead and explain what I mean by government lands. Those are our lands, everybody's, not his lands, not Nevada's lands, our lands, everybody's. And let's go ahead and say it very clearly. It is peak white privilege to pull guns on law enforcement in this country and walk away alive. So Baker Seeds has tried to say that they're being apolitical. They don't want to include the politics of Clive and Bundy in their spring festival. Obviously, by inviting him and putting a soapbox out for him, this is absolutely false. You are giving him a legitimate microphone, and with that microphone, he may or may not say incredibly racist things. He may or may not say things that are horrible for community, but you have provided him a soapbox. Baker Seeds, you've also said, well, you've invited a diversity of speakers. Okay, that's true. You definitely have invited a diversity of speakers. But you need to understand, that doesn't give you a pass to have a white nationalist. That is so absolutely flawed to think you have to have a balance of views by having average everyday people who are just trying to garden, balanced with a white nationalist. And it is true, Baker Seeds is also inviting a variety of other people. And what they're saying online anyway is that through diversity of speakers, they're making America truly great. Oof. Okay, y'all. Look, you're not making a room great by adding a racist. You're not making a community great by adding a racist. That same logic would insist that you bring serial killers. Because diversity, no, diversity is not a strength when you're inviting people who hurt people. Diversity is not a strength when you're inviting people who harm the land. Let's go ahead and talk about this idea that you can have Clive and Bundy here and not be supporting his political views. I find it very difficult to believe that you're not also interested in Clive and Bundy's politics. Here's the deal. Anybody who showed an odd interest in Hitler's art probably has an odd interest in Hitler's beliefs. If I knew somebody was interested in Hitler's art, do you think I would really ask their opinion on art? A land ethic, according to Aldo Leopold, is social, not antisocial. It's definitely clear that Clive and Bundy operates with antisocial land ethic. We need to look for modes of cooperation. Modes of cooperation, mechanisms of cooperation, versus this free-for-all competition. The government lands are set aside with the hope that people will work cooperatively to benefit from that land. But right now, his land relationship is purely economic. He wants all the privileges, but none of the obligations. When he lays claim to the arable lands out west that are public lands, what he's doing is he is claiming and bottlenecking the energy in the ecosystem. He's changing the lands there, and he's claiming that energy free of charge to himself. Let me read to you for you from Aldo Leopold on the land pyramid. Plants absorb energy from the sun. This energy flows through a circuit called biota, which may be represented by a pyramid consisting of layers. The bottom layer is the soil. The plant layer rests on the soil, the insect layer on the plants, the bird and rodent layer on the insects, and so on up through the various animal groups to the apex layer, which consists of the large carnivores. Let me quote Aldo Leopold on food chains. Food chains are the living channels which conduct energy upward. Food webs, or food chains, are the living conduits that channel energy upward through the food pyramid, through the trophic levels, ultimately to us. What he has done is a hostile, violent, armed takeover of a portion of the arable land and a portion of our food supply. Aldo Leopold on the ethic. Let me quote. An ethic, philosophically, is a differentiation of social from antisocial conduct. By being a racist, by separating himself out from portions of the country just because they're black, Cliven Bundy fails the community test. But he also fails the land ethic test. Anywhere in the US where there's arable land, we have to look at that scientifically as an entry for the sun's energy into our ecosystem. And what Cliven Bundy's doing by demanding, and his entitled demand for access to government lands, he's demanding a chokehold on energy flow into our ecosystem. And this is the same ecosystem, by the way, that should feed us all. And because he's racist, we know he doesn't mean all of us. But the sun provides us so much energy, but it only has so many ways to enter our ecosystem. And it does that through the arable land, part of which has been protected, where there's grazing allowed. He's certainly been allowed to graze on those lands, but he's being asked to pay a fair share to graze on those lands. And he refuses. He feels he's entitled to access to grazing, to access to the sun's energy, to access to the flow of energy through the ecosystem into our food supply without paying his fair share. And what's more, he believes he's entitled to that access and will enforce it with violence. So Cliven Bundy fails, Baker Seeds. And you've got to apply some sort of litmus test to the people you're going to invite. Because by giving them a platform, you are aligning yourself. You're saying, hey, this is good. Check this out. Come to our festival because we have a treat for you. This, what do we want to grow as a community? And this isn't just Baker Seeds. This is just everybody who's involved in gardening and farming. And let's go ahead and say homesteading, preppers, traditionalists, people who are all about the heritage. Can you please just take a minute and be a little critical? Because not everything our ancestors did was awesome, and not everything our current elders are doing is awesome. And sometimes our ancestors' legacy, that needs to be corrected. And sometimes our elders are acting out and doing wrong, and we cannot continue to give them a soapbox and pat them on the back for growing watermelons in the desert when they're failing entirely as a community member by being racist and as a steward of the land by not paying their fair share. We can't give this person a soapbox to continue talking about how to maintain a stranglehold on the food chain, on the trophic levels, on energy through an ecosystem, avoiding paying his fair share, holding lands for his own self-interest, for his own benefit, benefiting only the people that are within his racist circle, benefiting only the people who would agree with him and let him be. So let's grow, Baker Seeds and anybody else who's seeing this. Let's reject this racist, self-serving, energy-grabbing, white supremacist way of being. Can we dream of a way to grow and build that does not involve creating myths about how we might be better and creating this sense of entitlement that we get to just grab the lands, grab the energy, grab the food? I mean, really, if you're a prepper and you're aligning yourself with this person, are you looking forward to the day where you have your own little fiefdom, where you get a small cut because you decided to run with the violent, most powerful person? This is no way to behave. If we really want to survive and thrive well, we need to do this in a way that is pro-social and pro-land, that helps ecology, that helps each other. And Cliven Mundy is not that. Let's go ahead and again look to Aldo Leopold for just a minute. I have purposely presented the land ethic as a product of social evolution because nothing so important as an ethic is ever written. So as I'm making this video, I'm pretty sure Baker Seeds is still thinking about having Cliven Mundy. I do have a hope in my heart somewhere that somebody's going to have the right discourse with somebody at Baker Seeds, and that an ethic of what it takes to care for people as well as what it takes to care for the land, which ultimately cares for the people, will hopefully get through to Baker Seeds.